Hello students, in present video I am going to explain about 6th problem from journal lesson. This question I am taking from Telangana State Telugu Academy Inter First Year Accountancy Textbook. But this video is useful to all common students who want to know about journal lesson. First 5 problems video links are available in the description box and in icon. Let us start the problem. First transaction is on 1st January 2019. Transaction is started business with cash 25,000 rupees. In question, he has given the owner name as Atmaram. So Atmaram started business with cash 25,000 rupees. This is the transaction. While writing the journal entry, we should identify minimum 2 accounts from every business transaction. In this transaction, 2 accounts are: as cash is coming into the firm, cash account is 1 account, and Atmaram is giving that cash now, Atmaram account is another account. Always should remember, while writing journal entries, we should assume that we are working as an accountant under this firm. Means we should analyze each and every transaction from firm's point of view. For writing journal entries, there are 3 steps. First step is identification of 2 accounts. We identified the 2 accounts, cash account and Atmaram account. These 2 accounts we have in this present transaction. Second step is grouping. Grouping means account is divided into 3 types: personal account, real account, nominal account. If any account is opened with a person name or firm name, it is a personal account. If account is opened with an asset name, it is a real account. If account is opened with the expenditure name, loss name, income name and gain name, it is a nominal account. We should identify this cash account is a personal account or real account or nominal account. That is known as grouping. Cash is an asset, no? All assets come under real accounts. So cash account is a real account. Atmaram account. With the person name we opened this account. Therefore it is a personal account. Grouping is completed. Third step is apply the double entry principles. For real account, double entry principle is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming into the firm, debit cash account. For personal account, double entry principle is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Atmaram is giving cash to us now, he is a giver. Therefore, credit Atmaram's account. Owner name we should not write in the accounts. When owner name comes in credit, instead of writing that name, we should write capital word. Then final entry is cash account data to capital account. Narration is being business is started. Third day transaction is purchased computer 5000 rupees. This is purchase related transaction. 2 points we should observe now. What they purchased, how they purchased. They purchased computer. They purchased a fixed asset. As seller's name is not given, this is cash purchase. So fixed asset is purchased for cash. Firm purchased computer from one seller. As seller name is not given in the question, I have taken one imaginary name, X. And firm paid cash to him. Computer is coming, cash is going. 2 accounts are computer account and cash account. Both are assets. Both come under real accounts. Real account rules, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Computer is coming, debit computer account. Cash is going, credit cash account. And instead of computer word, don't write purchases word. If goods come, instead of goods, we should write purchases. If there is any fixed asset, then we need not to change the word. Then final entry is computer account data to cash account. Narration is being computer is purchased for cash. Sixth day transaction is purchased goods for cash 6000 rupees. Purchase transaction is given. We should observe 2 points. What they purchased, how they purchased. They purchased goods for cash. Goods are purchased for cash. Supplier's name is not mentioned. From supplier, goods are coming and we paid cash to him. Two accounts are goods account and cash account. Both are assets, both come under real accounts. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming, debit goods account, cash is going, credit cash account. When goods come in debit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. Transaction is purchase transaction. No? Then final entry is purchases account data to cash account. Narration is being goods are purchased for cash. Seventh day transaction is purchased goods on credit from Mahesh 8000 rupees. Purchase transaction is given. We should observe 2 points. First one, what they purchased. They purchased goods. Second one, how they purchased. They purchased on credit. From Mahesh, we purchased goods. Goods are coming. Cash is not going because this is credit purchases. Then, two accounts are goods account and Mahesh account. Why I am taking person name as an account? Because I should remember that in future I have to pay money to Mahesh. Mahesh is a creditor to me now. That is why in my books I have to open his account. So I should consider supplier's name here. Goods account is a real account because goods come under asset. Mahesh account is a personal account. Then real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming, debit goods account. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Mahesh is giving goods, he is a giver, credit Mahesh account. When goods are coming in debit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name, that is purchases. Then final entry is purchases account data to Mahesh account. Narration, being goods are purchased on credit. 10th day transaction is purchased goods for 7000 and paid by check. Purchase transaction is given. We should observe 2 points. What they purchased and how they purchased. They purchased goods. How they purchased? Supplier's name is not given. Therefore, it is a cash purchase. Firm issued a check to the supplier. Check purchase also comes under cash purchase only. Because supplier encashes that check. Firm purchased goods from supplier. Goods are coming into the firm. In return, firm issued a check to supplier. Then supplier goes to a bank where firm is maintaining a current account. Supplier presents that check to bank and from our account, from firm's account, bank pays money to supplier. This is the transaction. Two accounts we have to identify. First account is goods are coming to us, no? Goods account is one account. Then banker is paying money to supplier. Therefore bank account is another account. Don't take cash account because cash is not coming into the firm. Cash is not going from the firm. In this question, supplier's name is not available. Even though he gives supplier's name, we should not take supplier's name as an account here because check purchase also comes under cash purchase. We settled his account. Now we need not to record supplier's name in our books. These two are the accounts. Goods account is a real account because goods come under asset. Bank account. Bank means actually we write one organization name here. SBI account, Andhra Bank account. That is one firm, no? With a firm name, when we open any account, it comes under a personal account. So bank account is a personal account. Apply the double entry principles. For real account rule is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are coming into the firm, debit goods account. For personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Bank is giving money to supplier. Bank is a giver. Credit bank account. Goods, word is coming in debit side. When goods come in debit, instead of writing goods, we should write purchases word. Then final entry is purchases account data to bank account. Narration is being goods are purchased through check. 12th day transaction is sold goods for cash 10,000 rupees. When sales transaction is given to us, we should observe 2 points. What they sold, how they sold. They sold goods for cash. Goods are sold for cash. Customer name is not given. We sold goods to customer. Goods are going from the firm. This is cash sale. Customer paid cash to us. Cash is coming, goods are going. These two are the accounts. Customer name is not given in this question. Even though he gives customer's name, we need not to consider that. Because it is a cash sale. Already we received cash from customer. Now customer's name is immaterial to us. We need not to record his name in our books. Cash, goods, both are assets. Both come under real accounts. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming, debit cash account. Goods are going, credit goods account. When goods come in credit, instead of writing goods word, we should write transaction name. This is sales transaction. Write down sales account. Then final entry is cash account data to sales account. Narration, being goods are sold for cash. 15th day transaction is goods sold for 15,000, of which 8,000 received in cash and by a check 7,000 rupees. When sales transaction is given, we should observe 2 points now. First one, what they sold. Goods sold for 15,000. Firm sold goods. Second point, how they sold. Here, firm sold goods to customer for 15,000 rupees. Sales amount is 15,000. Customer has to pay 15,000 rupees. Out of this 15,000, customer paid 8,000 rupees in the form of cash, and for remaining amount 7,000 rupees, customer issued a check to us. Assume customer is maintaining his bank account in SBI. Actual procedure is, firm should go to SBI, firm should present customer's check, 7,000 worth check in SBI, and the firm should encash it. But when we are doing business daily, so many checks we receive in this firm. Can we go to all those banks? Impossible. Then what we do? We also maintain one bank account, no? We maintain current account in bank. Assume that our firm is maintaining a current account in HDFC. then instead of going to customer's bank, we deposit that check in our bank. Then bank collects money from customer's bank, and that amount will be deposited in our account. This is the transaction. Now accounts we should identify. Cash is coming to us 8,000. Therefore, cash account is one account. Next one, our bank is receiving money from customer's bank now. Therefore, our bank account is one account. Here you can see two banks. SBI is customer's bank. Don't consider that bank here. When we write bank account, then the meaning is we are writing our bank name, not customer's bank name. Then other account is we are selling goods to customer. Goods are going, therefore goods account is one account. Now cash is an asset, therefore it is a real account. Bank, actually we open HDFC account here, no? With the firm name, when we open any account, it is a personal account. Bank account is a personal account. Goods come under asset, no? So it is a real account. Apply the double entry rules. For real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash is coming to us, debit cash account. Personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here bank is receiving, our bank HDFC is receiving cash from customer's bank, no? Our bank is a receiver, therefore debit bank account. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods are going from the firm, so credit goods account. When goods word comes in credit, instead of writing that word, we should write sales account. Then final entry is cash account debtor, because cash is coming. Bank account debtor, because bank balance increased, to sales account. This is compound entry, because entry contains more than two accounts. When we get any compound entry, how to show the amounts? Two accounts are in debit now. Therefore, first debit column amounts we should write. 8,000 cash is coming. 7,000 bank balance is increased. Write down these two amounts. And according to dual aspect concept, for every debit, equivalent credit should be there. Therefore, total these two amounts and write down 15,000 for sales. Total sales amount is 15,000. Out of that, 8,000 we received in cash form. For another 7,000, we received a check. This check sale also comes under cash sale only, because we are converting the check into cash form. Narration is, being goods are sold, 8,000 received in cash and 7,000 received by check. So this is all about sixth problem. Hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you.